Good morning and welcome back to Planet Doug in Ho Chi Minh City. As you can probably see, I'm sitting on another Grab motorcycle here in Saigon. It's 9:30 in the morning, Sunday morning, beautiful day. The forecasts keep threatening us with thunderstorms, and there are thunderstorms in the afternoon quite often, but the mornings tend to be quite nice, so it's a better idea this time of year to plan your activities for the morning. And this morning's activity is a trip to a traditional market. Someone that I met here recently, a local English teacher, in fact, a Vietnamese woman named T, a friend of a friend, offered to guide me around a traditional local market. And it's about 5 kilometers away. I was going to take a bus to get out there, but I ran out of time this morning. So I had no choice but to hop on a Grab, and hey, that's no terrible thing. I get to shoot a little bit of video, and I'm using my 360 camera for this journey, just for fun. Get a nice view of me looking goofy in my Grab helmet, as always. And this market, I won't try to say the name of it. I'll wait until I get there and I have my guide who can give you the official Vietnamese pronunciation. I'll let her say the name of the market. I did a little bit of reading about it, and it is a market that specializes in products from central Vietnam. So from Hoi An, I believe. I think the name of the province is something like Quang Nam province. And there are a lot of comments on Google Maps from people who are from that district, and they live here in Ho Chi Minh City. And they miss the products from their home province. And they speak very highly of this market because they can go there and essentially get food from home. So, yeah, here we go. It's actually out near the airport, so it's a little bit of a journey to get there. And according to messages from T, when I first get there, where we're gonna meet is at or near a coffee shop. And she says there's a very special banh mi there. I guess based on central Vietnamese recipes and ingredients. So we'll see. We might start the day with a banh mi and a cup of coffee, and then we're going to go through the market. Yeah, it should be a lot of fun. As I said, T is an English teacher, and she's very comfortable speaking English. I met her one time already. Here we are, going through a classic roundabout situation. Looks like we're heading just over here to the right, so we don't actually have to go all the way around the roundabout. To go, because I have a camera in one hand and I'm holding on to him with the other. It's not really a comfortable time to get out my phone and check Google Maps. So I haven't been able to monitor our progress. Yeah, again, I have no idea where we are. I have no idea why I'm still wearing my glasses, my reading glasses. Yeah, the world suddenly looks much better now I took those off. You get so involved in shooting videos sometimes that half your brain is occupied, or 90% of your brain is occupied, and you forget about all these little details of life, like putting on your glasses, putting on your pants, things like that. Oh, look, a little nursery at the side of the road, selling plants. Yeah. This might be the airport road, and if it is the airport road, I've been here before a couple of times, but I don't recognize it. This feels like a brand new road. This has been so much fun. We're in the left lane now, so we must be getting close. We probably, yeah, we're gonna turn left here, I assume. Yeah, I love the way everybody tries to dive in front. But it does end up creating this little traffic jam every time. Heading down an alleyway. We must be getting very close. And when he drops me off, I'll just have to assume I'm in the right place. Hopefully it's a good ride for this guy, because we're out by the airport. Maybe he can pick up an airport fare to head back into town, since we had to come all the way out here. But actually, I find the distances in Saigon really manageable. The airport is like 6 kilometers away, which is crazy to me. It seems so close. And everywhere I go, feels like I'm not, it's a huge city, one of the biggest cities in the world, I guess, but to me, it feels smaller. I have no trouble getting anywhere by bus, on foot, or by Grab if I need to get somewhere faster. We're really going local now. It's amazing that these guys, yeah, how well they know their neighborhoods. And all these back alleys. Yeah, this could be the center or part of the market right here. And then I have to walk a few minutes to the coffee shop. Yeah. I think this is the right area. Cool. We'll see where he pulls over. Yeah, I'm recognizing one of the words, BAO, and that's the name of the market, I think. So I think we're in the right neighborhood anyway. Wow, we're really going deep. So we went through a market area, but maybe that wasn't my market. Sent this poor guy on a journey. And I hope he's not counting on me to recognize where we are supposed to stop, because I have no idea. Oh, we're heading into another market area. Oh, nice. I'm guessing this must be it. I guess the pin that I put on Google Maps was deep inside the Market Street. He's taking me right there. And that is something I've noticed in my time in Saigon, the detail the service is so detail oriented. People are very concerned to do okay. Is it market? Yeah. So he took me right into the heart of the market. All right. Hello. Yeah, so I'm here, right in the middle of the market. So I'm going to shut off my 360 camera now because I have to put it away so I can get out my my other phone and figure out where to go to meet T. All right, I'll check back in a minute.